Hey there, this is Dr. Sangeeta from Dental Pathshala, where we help you understand and learn dentistry better and easy way. And today we are going to be going over cephalometrics. Most students find it difficult to understand cephalometrics in ortho. So if you're falling to this category, you're not alone. So today's video will be discussing lines and planes in cephalometry. And based on the orientation of lines or the planes, we can classify into two categories which we'll be studying in this video. The first one is the horizontal planes or horizontal lines, the lines which are parallel to the floor. In the cephalometry, the lines which are placed horizontally, we'll be studying seven planes under this category. And the vertical planes, another one is vertical planes or vertical lines, the lines which are placed perpendicular to the floor, which are placed perpendicularly, we'll be studying four planes under this category. So let's get started. Before we get started, make sure you subscribe to this channel and click the bell icon. That way you get notified as soon as I release a video. So let's get started with the lines and planes in cephalometric, and it can be divided into two parts. As I've told you, horizontal planes, the lines which are placed horizontally or somewhere parallel to the floor in the cephalometric comes under horizontal plane, and we'll be studying seven planes under this category. And the other category is the vertical planes. We'll be studying four planes under vertical category, and the lines which are placed perpendicular to the floor. So these lines in cephalometry are obtained by joining the two points. Of course, a line is formed by joining the two points. So a line is obtained, and this line is actually obtained by joining the two points that are the cephalometric landmarks, which we have studied in the previous video. So based on these lines, either these lines are placed horizontally or these lines are placed vertically, we can categorize into the horizontal planes and the vertical planes. So the first plane we have is the SN plane. As I have been telling you, everything is there in the name. You break the name and you get everything about it. So SN plane, if we break SN plane into two parts, S and N. So the first point is S and the second point is N. So it is a line which connects point S to point N. Now S point is the center of the cella tersica is the S point, and N point is the anterior point on the frontonasal suture. So this is the nasion point, this is the cella point. If we connect these two points and draw a line, so this is our SN plane. This is a horizontal plane, and this plane represents the anterior cranial base, as this is present in the anterior part of the cranium. So this plane or this line represents the anterior cranial base. The second one we have is the Frankfort horizontal plane or FH plane. This plane is the gold standard for so many analysis, and this plane was introduced in a conference, anthropological conference, not by a person named Frankfort, rather a place which is in the Germany, a Frankfort place which is in the Germany, and this conference was held in 1884. So this Frankfort horizontal plane, you can remember it from PO. See, for bank, we give probationary officer. If you want to get into bank, so the entry level you get as a job for PO, that is the probational officer. So you can remember this from that. So it is a plane which connects the two points. The first one is the porion P, and the second one is the O point. Now, if you remember porion point, this is the external, if this is the external auditory meatus, P for peak. So the top of the external auditory meatus, which is the superior part of the external auditory meatus. And the O, which is the O means zero. If you see O, you look it as a zero. So zero is the lowest thing. So the lowest point on the floor of the orbit is your point O. And the highest point on the external auditory meatus, or the superior point on the external auditory meatus is P. As you can say, peak. P signifies peak, so it is the highest point. So a line which is drawn from porion to orbital is our Frankfort horizontal plane, which is a very important plane for so many analysis, for certain analysis. So this is the PO, which is our Frankfort horizontal plane. Now the next plane we have is the occlusal plane. This is a line drawn the occluding surfaces. So going from posterior to the anterior, posterior occlusion surfaces of premolars and molars, we draw a line. And in case of mixed dentition period, you draw a line occluding the deciduous molars. So a line which is drawn from the occluding surfaces of posterior teeth, molars and premolars, and which is extended anteriorly up to the anterior region, this is our occlusal plane, which is also again a horizontal plane. Now the next fourth one we have is the palatal plane. A palatal plane is drawn from point ANS, the anterior nasal spine, and the point PNS, which is our posterior nasal spine. The posterior, it is at the junction of the actually anterior wall of the pterygopalatine fossa and the floor of the nose. So this marks the distal limit of the maxilla, and this is our anterior nasal spine, ANS point, which is the anterior tip of our sharp bony process in the maxilla, and it is in the midline of the lower margin of anterior nasal opening. So we draw a line from ANS to PNS, which is our palatal plane. So this is present in the palate. Thus the name palatal plane is given. Coming to the mandibular plane, which is very important. Again, this mandibular plane actually in cephalometry, it is used in different ways. As based on the analysis, the most common analysis, we have three analysis. We will be studying in the next upcoming videos, the Downs analysis, the Steiners analysis, and the tweeds analysis, which is the most important analysis. So the Downs analysis, it is a line connecting the gonion to the menton. Now the gonion, this is our gonion, which is the angle of the mandible, which is present at the junction of the actually the ramal plane and the mandibular plane. So gonion is a point which is present at the angle of the mandible. So Downs analysis, it is a line which connects gonion to the menton. If you remember in the previous video, I have told you me, which represent the inner self, which is the innermost point on the bony chin. So for Downs analysis, mandibular plane is a point, is a line which connects gonion to menton. So menton to gonion. This is for Downs analysis, the mandibular plane. The mandibular plane for Steiner's analysis is the point, is a line connecting from gonion to gonathion. Now the pogonion, if you remember in the previous video, pogonion is the anterior most point on the bony chin, and if we connect those two points and if we draw a perpendicular line intersecting it, there comes the point gonathion. So for Steiner's analysis, from gonion to gonathion, the mandibular plane is from gonion to gonathion. This is for Steiner's analysis. And for Tweed's analysis, it simply says a line tangent to the lower border of the mandible. So a line which will be tangent to the lower border of mandible will be this. So this is for Tweed's analysis, which have make us easier to understand the mandibular plane. Now the next, second last, the sixth horizontal plane we have is the basionasion plane. As the name itself indicates, it's a point, it's a line which is drawn from basion to nasion. Nasion, as we all know, the anterior most point on the frontonasal suture, and the basion is at, it is the median point on the anterior margin of the foramen magnum. Basion is this one. So this will be basion nasion plane will be, this is our nasion point, this is our basion point. So there is a line connecting from basion to nasion. It is a kind of an oblique line, but somewhere close to horizontal. The last horizontal plane we have is the Bolton's plane. and it is a line connecting the Bolton point to the nasion. So the Bolton point is the highest point on the occipital bone, and this is a line which connects Bolton's to the nasion. Again, it is somewhere oblique, but it comes under horizontal plane because it is close to the horizontal. So till now we have studied the horizontal plane. In that we have studied SN plane, which is a line connecting point S to point N. S is the midpoint of the cella, which is our cella turcica, to the nasion, which is the anteriormost point on the frontonasal suture. So the next one we have is the Frankfort horizontal plane, the FH plane. It is a line which connects the PO, Porion, to orbital. Orion is the superiormost point on the external auditory meatus, and orbital is the lowermost zero. You can see it as a zero, which signifies the lower value. So it is present on the lower floor of the orbit. So P to O is our Frankfort horizontal plane. Occlusal plane is the line which intersects the occluding surfaces of the premolar extending anteriorly. The palatal plane is from ANS to PNS. The mandibular plane is studied in three categories. The first one is the Downs, Steiners, and the last one is the Tweeds. For Downs, we have a line connecting from gonion to menton. Menton is the innermost point on the bony chin. So for Steiners, it is gonion to gnathion, which connects the point menton and the pogonion. And for Tweeds, it is line tangent to the lower border of the mandible. Next plane we have is the basion-nasion plane, which connects basion point to the nasion point. So this is the basion-nasion plane. And the Bolton's plane is the point connecting Bolton point to the nasion point. So the next one is our vertical planes. We have four vertical planes. The first one is APOG. APOG, as everything is in the name and we break the name, we get everything out of it. So APOG is a line which connects point A to pogonion. Point A is our subspinal. We have studied in the previous video about anatomical landmarks. So vertical will draw from green. So this is our point A, which is our subspinal. Point A to pogonion, this is our APOG line, which is a vertical line. Now the facial plane. Facial plane is drawn from N. You have to remember this facial plane. We'll be studying facial plane a lot under Downs analysis, which is our next video. So the facial plane is our NPOG. APOG is our APOG line, and you have to break. See, NPOG is our facial plane. So a line which is drawn from N to pogonion, point N to pogonion, is our NPOG line. So this is our NPOG line, which tells about the facial profile. So this is our facial plane. From N to POG is our facial plane. Now the next one is the facial axis. Facial axis is somewhere oblique. It is present from PTM point, the pterygomaxillary fissure, to the gnathion. So this is our facial axis. It is just an axis. So this is our facial axis. E plane is our soft tissue line, or aesthetic line we can say. It is a line which connects the most anterior point on the chin and the most anterior point on the tip of the nose. So this is a soft tissue line which is drawn, which connects the tip of the nose to tip of the chin. So we have studied four vertical planes and seven horizontal planes. This finishes our planes and lines in cephalometrics. Next video we'll be studying Downs analysis, and one by one we'll finish all three analysis: the Downs analysis, Steiners, and the Tweeds analysis. I hope that help you understand and learn the topic. If you have any questions, leave in the comment below. If you enjoy the video, like it, share it, subscribe it, and I'll see you soon.